Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to prepare cat halwa and I am preparing this because one of my subscribers requested for it. Let's see how to prepare.
The main ingredient for this recipe is carrot and I am using 750 grams of carrots today. Firstly, let's peel off the skin of carrots. Now let's grate all the carrots using a grater. Next, we can measure and take 4 cups of full fat milk. Full fat milk is most preferable for this recipe because it gives rich flavor and taste to it. After that, use the same cup to measure 4 cups of grated carrot. The carrot shouldn't be measured loosely or tightly packed, rather it should be measured medium packed. Just pat on the carrots gently to measure it properly. Now let's start by placing a heavy bottomed pan on medium flame and then add the measured milk into it. As the whole preparation takes us about 1.5 hours, it's advisable to use a large heavy bottomed pan. Once the milk is boiled, let's add the measured 4 cups of grated carrot into it. The carrot should be completely immersed in milk and let it cook for some time. So we have to stir it frequently to deglaze the pan and make sure the stove is on medium flame at all times. After 45 minutes to 1 hour, look for this consistency where the carrot is fully cooked and the whole mixture has reduced to half. Once this desired consistency is reached, add 2 tablespoons of ghee or clarified butter. Now keep another pan on side and add 1 teaspoon of ghee or clarified butter and fry nuts like cashews and almonds until it turns golden brown and aromatic. After 15 minutes, add about 10 tablespoons of white sugar, but if you prefer it to be very sweet, add 2 more tablespoons. Then mix it until the sugar is completely dissolved and the mixture gets thick. Next, I'm crushing 4 pods of green cardamom to get only the skin of it. Now we can add the cardamom peel into the mixture and this gives nice flavor and aroma to the halwa. Next, add all the fried nuts into the mixture and I'm saving a few for garnishing. After 10 to 15 minutes, you can see the halwa has thickened a lot and at this stage, add 1 more tablespoon of ghee. Mix it for 2 minutes and switch off the flame as the halwa will thicken a little more as it cools.
That's it, our recipe is ready. This can be eaten either cold or hot with a scoop of vanilla ice cream. Please try this at home and let me know your comments. To watch more videos like this, please subscribe to my channel. Also click the bell icon. See you later. Bye.